Hello, I'm Sharon Bolt and I'm the founder of Good Dogs. I'm a dog expert who's been featured in more than 35 different newspapers, magazines, TV and radio stations, and I'm regularly featured on BBC Radio Sussex and Surrey. I've created a series of videos for people who want to become professional dog trainers, giving tips on how you can become a dog trainer, how to work with animals, and how to have a successful dog training career. Is it your dream to be able to work with dogs and have a dog training career? If you're the type of person who'd love to work with animals, then becoming a dog trainer would probably be an ideal choice for you. With the increased number of dog attacks, dog bites, and dog owners at their wits' end with their dogs' unwanted behaviour, there is certainly a demand for more professional dog trainers and an opening for the right people to have successful dog training careers. So let's talk about how to become a dog trainer. Now, what I've discovered along my dog trainer journey is that there are three essential parts needed in order to become a successful dog trainer. Number one, a strong mindset with positive beliefs and expectations. Number two, dog training knowledge and experience. And number three, business knowledge and knowing the right marketing strategies. Now in this video, I'm going to focus on one of these vital parts and give you some tips about dog training, specifically about recall training. Are you ready? Good, let's get started. Now my advice is only to let your dog off the lead when they are responding well and walking by your side first on the lead. Why? Because until you have communicated to your dog that you are in charge of the walk, there's a strong possibility they will do whatever they like when off the lead. Now, I think most dog owners would agree that it's joyful watching happy and well-balanced dogs enjoying their freedom, playing and burning off excess energy off the lead. However, this is not an enjoyable experience for you if you're dreading an incident happening or are anxious that your dog may not come back or will only do so when they're ready. So here's what to do. First of all, you need to teach your dog the come command. Now, a good place to start is in your home and back garden, as there are a limited number of distractions and interesting smells there compared to a park. Now, the best way to teach your dog the come command is to say their name and then the word come. When they come to you, give them their favourite treat and say the word come as you release the treat. So they associate that the word come means that they are to come to you. When your dog is responding well to the come command at home, next take them to a park and repeat the same training with them on a long training or extendable lead. Now keep doing this until you feel confident to let them off the lead, having taught them to come when you call. Sometimes dogs simply haven't understood what they're supposed to do when you say their name and are not being naughty. They just have never been taught the come command. In order to help you with your dog trainer career, I've written an ebook that you can download for free, which is called Three Simple Steps to Becoming a Successful Dog Trainer. Now, these steps consist of number one, the vital part your mindset, beliefs and expectations play in becoming a successful dog trainer. Number two, the essential part dog training knowledge plays in becoming a successful dog trainer. And number three, the crucial part that business and marketing strategies play in becoming a successful dog trainer. Now, during the book, I explain about these three areas and give you tips on how to get on the right dog trainer path. I also reveal the secrets on how I first became a professional dog trainer. I hope you're not too shocked. Now, you can get the ebook now by clicking on the link if it shows on the screen or in the description box below.